A very good morning to all of you. Hope you are fit and healthy. Before starting with the next chapter, I would like to ask you a few questions. What type of government do we have? Yes, democratic government. So what is democracy? Okay, power to the people to vote. That means democratic government is a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. In a democracy, people expect the government to work for their welfare. And this could be done through the provision of education, health, employment, housing, or the development of roads, electricity, etc. All these facilities could be enjoyed only if we are healthy. So children, today we will examine the meaning and problems related to health. We are going to start with chapter 2, civics, role of the government in health. Today we are going to cover two topics, what is health and health care in India. Health is an important issue for everyone. So children, what does health mean? Does it mean our capacity to remain free from illness or injuries, or you can say to be disease free? But health isn't only about disease. Agar aapko koi bimari nahi hai, iska matlab aap swasth hai, aisa nahi hai. Apart from disease, several other factors are also there that contribute to the good health. For example, agar saaf peene ka paani ho aur pollution free environment ho, so we are likely to be healthy. If we get adequate food, hygienic conditions and a sound state of mind, that is without mental strain, then we are healthy. So children, health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely the absence of disease. Coming on to the next topic, health care in India. Open to page 20 of your books, you can see there are two columns. After reading these two columns, you have to provide a title to these columns. Here we will examine some of the aspects of healthcare in India. We are going to compare and contrast the situation expressed in the first and the second column. If we look at the first column, there are some facts that will give you an idea about the present state of healthcare services in our country. Whereas, when you look at the second column, these facts regarding the state of healthcare in our country, which will give you a completely different picture. There is no doubt that we have a large number of doctors, clinics and hospitals, money, knowledge and an experienced pool of professionals who can run various healthcare systems. But in spite of all these, we are unable to provide necessary healthcare facilities to all people. In this chapter, we will look at some of the reasons for this. I am going to tell you the story of Hakim Sheikh. He was a member of Paschim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti, an organization of agricultural laborers in West Bengal. He accidentally fell off a running train and suffered head injuries and was in a very serious condition. He needed immediate treatment. He was taken to a government hospital, but they refused to admit him because they did not have spare beds. Some hospitals refused because they did not have facility or specialized doctors. He spent 14 hours in critical state and finally he was admitted in a private hospital where he received treatment. He spent a lot of money on his treatment. Because of this, angry and upset Hakim Sheikh filed a case in the court. So children, read the story again and imagine that if you are a judge in the court, what would you say to Hakim Sheikh? Thank you and have a nice day. Hello children, yesterday we started with civics, chapter 2, role of the government in health, and we covered two topics, first what is health and second health care in India. Hope you understood the topics well.
तो चलिए हम एक क्विक रिकैप कर लेते हैं. व्हाट इज हेल्थ? हेल्थ इज नॉट ओनली टू बी डिजीज फ्री बट इट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स फैक्टर्स दैट अफेक्ट हेल्थ लाइक क्लीन ड्रिंकिंग वाटर, पॉल्यूशन फ्री इन्वायरमेंट, हेल्दी फूड टू ईट एक्सेट्रा. Living in good spirit and without mental strain is also an important aspect of health. Although all resources are available in India, but we still are not able to get proper medical facilities and treatment. Today we are going to cover the next topic, healthcare services, which are divided into two categories, public health service, private health services. But before that, let me tell you a story which is there in your book on page number 22 and 23 as a comic strip, The Cost of a Cure. Aman and Ranjan are good friends. Ranjan belongs to a well-to-do family, whereas Aman's parents have to struggle to make ends meet. Both of them suffered from viral fever and had to visit a hospital. Ranjan said, he went to a private hospital with his dad. It looked like a 5-star hotel with best of facilities. They had to pay Rs. 500 there. Everything was really clean. Doctors were friendly. I had few blood tests and doctor prescribed some medicines and rest. Whereas Aman visited a big government hospital with his Abba, where he had to wait in a queue for a long time. After the doctor examined him, he went for some tests. For that also, they had to wait in a long queue. The test results came after 3 days. He had viral fever and doctor gave him one fever-reducing medicine. Ranjan said, my hospital was nice, but the medicines given were many and whole treatment was costly. Whereas Aman's treatment did not cost much, but it was time-consuming. So children, from the above comic strip, we can say that healthcare facilities are divided into two categories, public health services and private health services. But before going or before understanding public health services and private health services, you need to understand what is public service and what is private service. Public service, an activity or service that is meant for all people in the country and mainly is organized by the government, like schools, hospitals, telephone services, etc. Private service, an activity or service that is organized by an individual or company for their own benefit is termed as private service. Coming on to public health and private health services, public health services are run by government, while private health services are managed by individuals or companies, as we have seen before. Public health services are found both in rural and urban areas, but private health services are concentrated in urban areas only. Public health services provide healthcare facilities either free or at low cost, whereas private health services are mainly run for profit. We can often see huge rush in government hospitals, but private hospitals are maintained properly and don't face such long queues there. So children, that's all for today. Thank you and stay safe.
Good morning, children. Today, we will continue with chapter number 2, Role of Government in Health. Till now, we have discussed about what is health, healthcare in India, public and private healthcare services. Now, we will discuss whether adequate healthcare is available to all Indians. In India, we see that lots of private services are increasing, but public services are not. Most of the private healthcare services are available in cities. In fact, now there are large companies that run hospitals and some are engaged in manufacturing and selling medicines. The cost of the private healthcare services are rather high. Medicines are expensive. Many people cannot afford them, and sometimes they have to borrow money when there is illness in the family. Some private hospitals and clinics encourage wrong practices to earn more. For example, they are found to prescribe expensive medicines, injections, or saline for treatment when simple and cheaper medicines are sufficient to cure. Those who are poor, every illness in the family is a cause of great distress. The situation becomes more worse when it happens again and again. These families do not get enough food to eat. They are not provided with basic needs like food, drinking water, proper housing, clean surrounding, etc. And thus, they are more likely to fall ill. The expenses on illness make their condition more miserable. Children, sometimes it is not money that prevents people from getting proper medical treatment. Women, for example, are not taken to a doctor on a regular basis. Women's health concerns are considered to be less important than the health of men in the family. Many tribal areas have few health centers and they do not run properly. The health situation of people of our country is not so good. It is the responsibility of the government to provide healthcare services to all its citizens, especially the poor. However, health is dependent both on basic needs and healthcare services. Hence, it is important to work on both in order to improve the health situation of our country. And this can be done. Look at the following examples. In 1996, the Kerala government made some major changes in the state. 40% of the entire state budget was given to the panchayats. They could plan according to their requirements. This made possible for the village to make sure that proper planning was done for water, food, women's development, and education. This meant that water supply schemes were checked, the working of school and Anganwadis was ensured, and specific problems of the village were taken up. Health centers were also improved. All this helped to improve the situation. Let us take another example. Costa Rica is considered to be one of the healthiest countries in South America. Several years ago, Costa Rica took a very important decision and decided not to have an army. This helped the Costa Rican government to spend the money on health, education, and other basic needs of the people. The Costa Rican government believes that a country has to be healthy for its development and pays a lot of attention to the health of its people. The Costa Rican government provides safe drinking water, sanitation, nutrition, and housing. Children, this is all for today.